Hello everyone, myself Rohini Mirgu, talking about cylindrical coordinate system. Learning outcomes. At the end of this video, you will be able to define the volume element in the cylindrical coordinate system. You will be able to write the equations for differential length, surface area and volume in the cylindrical coordinate system. You will be able to figure out the minimum and maximum ranges for different coordinate axes. So, before I move further, can we just revise the and can we just list the types of coordinate systems? So, types of coordinate systems are Cartesian or rectangular coordinate system having coordinates x, y, z, cylindrical coordinate system, rho, phi, z, spherical coordinate system are theta phi. Now in this video I'll be talking about cylindrical coordinate system which has coordinates rho phi z. So cylindrical coordinate system consists of two planes. Which planes? Phi constant and z constant planes. So one plane is phi constant, which is shown in yellow color, and z constant plane, which is shown in violet color. Then it also consists of one cylinder, which is rho constant cylinder, which is shown in pink color. The cylinder is shown in pink color. So these three together forms the cylindrical coordinate system. One cylinder and two planes. The cylinder is rho constant cylinder. Planes are phi constant and z constant planes. So here the animated cylindrical coordinate system is shown. Here you can see that this green one, which is changing, is nothing but rho. This is rho. Green one cylinder is a rho. Whereas this red one, which is moving around, is a plane. This red plane is nothing but phi constant plane. When it stops at the particular point, that time the phi is constant. Now you can see this another blue one. Plane which is changing with respect to height, it is moving along the z axis. This is z constant plane. At this point, z has some fixed value. When it stops at the particular point, that time the z has a fixed value, so it is a z constant plane. A point rho phi z in cylindrical coordinate system can be located by intersection of all these three planes, that is the cylinder, which is rho constant cylinder, then the z constant plane, this is z constant plane, and phi constant plane, this is phi constant plane. So intersection of these three will give us the point P, which is rho, phi and z. So I get this point P. Simple way, I can show it like this also. I can show a cylinder here. I can consider some point at having the radius rho as of the cylinder z at the particular height z and making an angle phi with respect to x axis. So this to be remembered, phi is the angle made with respect to x axis. Now can I write differential lengths in the cylindrical coordinate system? Yes, we will be able to write the differential lengths as we have written in Cartesian. We can write in the cylindrical as well. As there are three lengths along the three axes, which axis? The axis is rho, r, rho, phi and z. For these three length, three axes, we can write the lengths as d rho, rho d phi, dz. Now you may say, why it's rho d phi? Why not just d phi? As we have written like in Cartesian, dx, dy, dz. Here also expected like that. But let me tell you, phi is an angle. Phi is not a length. So to convert it in the length, we need to multiply with rho. But why only rho? Let me explain you here. So this length, which is vertical, is dz. Fine. The length in the radial direction this way is d rho. Now the question comes of phi. So when I go like this is phi, and if I move in the same direction in by d phi, this part is d phi. When this is d phi, I need this length actually. I want this length actually. So when I want this length, I should multiply that. This is a small angle, d phi. So I should multiply it with this length and then I can get this length, which is d phi angle. So this length will be rho, this length, into the angle d phi. So it is rho d phi and not just d phi. Why we cannot just take d phi? Because d phi is an angle, it's not a length. So to take it as a length, it should be multiplied with rho. Rho d phi is a length. So dl bar is d rho a rho bar plus rho d phi a phi bar plus dz a z bar. So we can write the differential lengths accordingly. Differential surface or area, yes, we are able to write that also. We can take a small section of a cylinder, a small volume element of the cylinder, and then we are able to write the surfaces. The surface is a vector quantity, it is a ds bar, so it should be along with some unit vectors. So when I am writing the different surfaces, let us say this surface, if I am writing, I should multiply the two lengths. Which are two lengths here? Here the circular part as well as vertical part. So I can say it is rho d phi into dz. So when I have written rho d phi into dz, the direction should be surely the third coordinate, which is a rho bar. This is if for the front part. The back part, back of that, the same volume element will be shown with minus a phi. Do not correlate this 1, 2, 3 with this. Do not correlate this 1, 2, 3 with this one. So these are the surface names which I have given. Okay. So DS2 I have explained, as it is on the opposite side, the same surface with the opposite direction of the unit vector is DS2. DS3, if I want to write, which is, you can see here, vertical length dz and the inward and outward length, which is d rho dz, and the direction should be surely the third vector, that is a phi bar. So this is if it's right side, the left surface will be with the minus a phi. Similarly, I can write DS5. DS5, if I want to write, I can multiply it as the two lengths, as the inward-outward direct change is d rho. Then this length is rho d phi. So multiplication of these is rho d rho d phi, and direction is upward az. If I want to write for bottom one, it will be with minus az. So this way I can write all the six surfaces for the small volume element in the cylindrical coordinate system. Can I write differential volume? Yes, it's very simple to write a differential volume. Volume is nothing but multiplication of three lengths. So which are the three differential lengths? D rho. It's not just d phi, it's rho d phi and dz, isn't it? So I have shown here in the diagram as well. D rho, rho d phi and dz. Then I can write a dv. Dv is a scalar quantity which is multiplication of these three. It is rho d rho d phi dz. Yes, we can also write the ranges for the different axes. Like rho is ranging from 0 to infinity. Why 0? Why not minus infinity? Because rho is a radius. We always measure radius from some center or the reference point, and then we measure it. So rho is, as it is a radius, its starting point is 0 and it can go maximum to infinity. As you can see, this cylinder can go up to infinity, but its starting is 0. Radius is 0. Phi, as you can see here, phi with respect to x-axis, it is from x equal to 0, sorry, phi equal to 0 to phi is equal to 2 pi. And z, as it is vertical variation, it is from again minus infinity to plus infinity. Z is same as in Cartesian coordinate system. Unit vectors, if I want to take the self dot product, it is always easy. A rho by a rho dot a rho is 1, a phi dot a phi is equal to 1, a z dot a z is 1. But when I want to take the cross product, I should follow this triangle. A rho to a phi bar, a phi bar to a z bar, and a z bar to a rho bar. A rho bar cross a phi bar, a rho bar cross a phi bar results in a z bar. But if I go reverse, like a phi cross a rho, that means I am going in the opposite direction of this arrow. So in that case, my result is third unit vector only, but with the minus sign, minus a z bar. Similarly, we can see here a phi bar cross a z bar is a rho bar, but a z bar cross a phi bar, a z bar cross a phi bar is minus a rho bar. And we can also find out it like a z bar cross a rho bar is equal to a phi bar, and but a rho arrow bar cross az bar, I'm going in the opposite direction of the arrow, so it is minus of a phi bar. So this way we can find the cross products of the unit vectors in a cylindrical coordinate system. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you.